when the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case. I could offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. When the evening shadows and the stars appear and there is no one there to dry your tears, I could hold you for a million years to make you feel my love. I know you haven't made your mind up yet, but I would never do you wrong. Out in my mind where you belong. I'd go hungry, I'd go black and blue, I'd go crawling down the avenue. No, there's nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love.
Oh my gosh, that's beautiful.
Does it have a long train? I can't tell from here.
It's like 3 feet, I think.
Can we move on?
So cute.
Thank you.
when my heart was wrapped in clover. Nothing that I could do.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
To all who are gathered here, welcome. I'm going to apologize up front. It astounds me every time I see real love. And I see that with you too. Excuse me. People in my church know that I'm pathetic when it comes to this. But I've been very close to the Cranston family for many, many years. Probably 40. And in a way, it's a very distant way, all these girls feel like they're ours. We babysat Tamara, Kristen. I think we were out of the babysitting game by the time Rebekah came around, but we love you guys. And we're here to celebrate a tremendous, tremendous day where you guys commit your lives to each other. Can't get any better than that. We're here to join Josh and Becca in holy matrimony. It's not just matrimony. This is ordained by God. Marriage is an institution created and established by God, which really does, regardless of what our society says, it serves as a foundation for life on this earth. Ultimately, marriage is God's object lesson to us, because it's how he demonstrates how he loves us through the marriage relationship. This isn't in the notes, but he talks about the different duties that the wives and husbands have to each other, but the one that really sticks out to me is, husbands, love your wives the way Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. God loves us so much, he gave himself to save us. He wants you to give yourself to nurture and save her. She's precious. He's precious. Those directions go both ways. Back at the very beginning, God said, it's not good for the man that he should be alone, and I will make him and help meet for him. Somebody suitable, compatible, somebody to love and to be loved by. It seems like an old story, but it's really happened. The Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. He took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, made he a woman, brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Very familiar story. But I read this many years ago, and it just rang so true when I read it, and I have to share it whenever I am honored to stand in this spot. But the woman was taken from man's rib. Not his head, not his foot, the rib. Not the head that she should rule him. Not the foot that you should stomp on her, but from the rib, next to the heart, to stand side by side, walk through life as one. Josh, Becca, as you join together today, you're establishing your own family, your own future. Walk through this life hand in hand, pulling together, united. Don't get on different pages. You're a team. Don't let anybody drive a wedge between you. Don't let anybody play one against the other. You're a team. You're one flesh. I encourage you to put God in the center of your lives. His word, his principles, his love. This world will offer you a lot of advice based on human reasoning, but God's word is true, and it'll never change. Build a foundation on something that is really permanent. Love each other. Serve each other. Prefer each other. My wife knows all about prefer each other because she says, where do you want to eat? I don't know, where do you want to eat? You know, but it goes deeper than that. Seek the other's happiness. Seek the other's fulfillment. There's plenty of time to have a great time for yourself, but make it a pursuit to make the other one happy. Choose to be happy. Some people, I've met them, have an eternal scowl on their face and just everything's wrong with the world. Just don't be that person. Just decide to be happy. Mm-hmm. Determine today that trouble, and yes, you will have trouble, but the trouble will pull you together and it won't drive you apart. How you deal with good times and bad times should have one answer, and that's as a team. So I just want you to enter into this glorious stage of your life committed to each other's happiness. Now, Josh and Becca have written their own vows that they're going to share with each other. I encourage both of you to really speak up so that not only the people can hear, but it can be caught on tape and the recordings and all of that. But we're going to allow them to do that right now. I think Becca was first, right? Yeah.
Ten learning years, learning about one another, what we love, what we don't love. I love the strength that you bring to our family. Your laugh is irresistible, your compassion immeasurable. I promise to always work hard on our family. My eyes are on the future, with strength, devotion, and even more love than yesterday. You are able, with your fun and playful personality, to make people laugh. I look forward to many more laughs together. I look forward to growing as a family. I'll remember to speak tenderly through angered emotions. I'll remember the man I fell in love with and continue to love you through life's changes. I will remain the girl that you fell in love with and always remember who she is, only changing for the better. I've always joked about how lucky you are to have me, but I remember the day I stared at you feeling so lucky to have you. The father of my children, my truest friend, and my deepest love. I promise that you, Araby, Bailey, Aubrey, and Wesley will always be my number one.
to you, Becca. I love you. From the moment I first saw you, I knew you're the one I wanted to share my life with. Your beauty, heart and mind, have inspired me to be the best person I can be. I will always strive to give you the best of myself from this day forward. Rebekah, I keep on falling in love with you over and over again. In the time that we've been together, I truly believe that this is one key element to a perfect marriage. And with that, I promise to respect you as the person you are, with your own interests, desires, and needs, and to realize that those are sometimes different, but no less than my own. I promise to keep myself open to you, to let you into my fears, my feelings, my secrets, and my dreams. I promise to love you for eternity, respecting you, honoring you, and being faithful to you as long as I live.
I'd like to ask the children to come up now. Josh has a family promise he's going to read to the to his children.
So along with the marriage and the promises between Becca and I, we think it is just as much a promise to our children as they are just as much a part of this as we are. So we want to take this time to also be sure that as part of this promise to each other, that we also make a promise to our children. We have four awesome children, Araby, Bailey, Aubrey, and Wesley. Unfortunately, Bailey was not able to be here with us, but he is in our hearts as we give this promise. First and foremost, we promise to always make sure that God has a place in your hearts. We promise to love you with our heart and soul. We promise to take care of you and nurture you and inspire you, no matter what the situation seems it may be. We promise to always be there as a friend, and most importantly, as a parent, always with your best interests in mind.
Okay, now if everybody would bow their heads, we're going to pray for this family. Lord Jesus,
Dad.
As Josh and Becca are joined
Dad.
Today in marriage,
Dad.
Let them feel your presence.
Dad.
Let the sacredness of this moment be forever woven into the very fabric of their lives. Let their children feel the love and safety of a strong home. A home where you, Lord, are welcome. Guide them. Bless them. Keep them. Prosper them. Help all of them, both parents and children, to grow as individuals and as a family unit. Help them discover their talents, skills, and gifts. Celebrate with them during times of victory and sustain and comfort them when they are faced with challenging circumstances. Above all, Lord, be with them. Help them to always make room in their hearts for you. Help them to love you. Help them to realize that you are the source of all their happiness. In Jesus' name. Amen. We'll train first. You want to hear me first? Oh, you're going to do that. You're going to do the lockbox next. Okay. Josh and Becca are going to take these vows that they've just shared with each other and lock them in this lockbox right here while a song is playing.
My love, here I stand before you.
Josh and Becca, you've publicly exchanged vows, and you've locked them in a box. Now lock each other in your hearts. I already heard this in your vows, but I was so happy to hear it. Let tenderness and kindness be the prevailing attitude in your relationship. Josh and Becca, by the power vested in me by God and the state of Ohio, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride. And as in everything, there's always a mistake. We're going to kiss twice. Isn't that cool? We're going to exchange rings also. See? Never mind. I just had it out of order, and now that I got to here, I didn't see that. So please present the ring to Josh. He's going to present this to Becca. Josh, I'd like you to repeat after me. This is a simple one. As a token and a pledge. As a token and a pledge. Josh, you say, you're saying this to her. And this goes on your left hand.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Okay. Okay, as a token and a pledge.
As a token and as a pledge.
Of the vows between us made.
The vows between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Put it on. Left hand. Becca, repeat after me. As a token and a pledge.
As a token and a pledge.
Of the vows between us made.
Of the vows between us made.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
And because it was so good the first time, you can kiss again. Just give her a little kiss. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Josh and Becca Cumberworth. Give them a hand.
This thing called love, it cries in a cradle all night. It swings and it jives, it shakes all over like a jellyfish. I kinda like it. Crazy little thing called love. There goes my baby.
Everybody, instead of a receiving line, they're going to come out that front door and share a toast with everybody on the lawn over here. So please make your way over here by that table and get a glass, and they will have a toast. And then after that, they'll take pictures, and everybody, all of us, will just sit up in the reception area awaiting the reception. So we'll release to go over there.
Couldn't get away from the C letter.
I know. Initials are still the same.
Thank you.
girl standing on there looked so pretty.
Please welcome the bridal party today, Richard and Candace. Nice big round of applause for them. Next, please welcome Kurt and Kristen. Someone be ready to catch them, please. Next, please welcome Derek and Tamara. Please welcome Matt and Kelsey.
Mom, you okay?
I'm good.
Whoa.
I can't get off of my head. I'm killing
whoever thought of this. Down here, what are we doing
here? All right, please welcome the little ones, Wesley, Aubrey, and... Maybe not. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new Mr. and Mrs. Cumberworth, Josh and Becca.
Who's that go to?
It was cursed, but he had to grab another one.
Okay, we're all gonna dance.
Okay, maybe I'll start. I just wanted to address someone special that's not here. My grandmother. She passed away a couple years ago, and I wish that she could be here to see this day. But
They made me go first down the steps, and I didn't fall, yes. So I think I can do a toast first. Maybe. I can get my paper open. Okay. Short and sweet, that's what Becca wanted. So I met Becca through work about 9 years ago. Over the years, we've had so many wild and crazy and fun adventures together. And just recently, we both decided to start our families. And I'm so excited that our children are both best friends like you and I. And although we feel much older and much more tired, I can't imagine anyone else that I would rather have many more wild and crazy adventures together.
And you're my friend, not just because you're my sister, but you're my friend because you want to be. And I'm your friend because I want to be. We met when you were born. And I've known you for a while. I just want you to know how much I love you. And so happy for you and Josh. And I remember when we met. I didn't like you at first. But I'm the protective older sister. You've grown on me. And it's been awesome to see who you are with my sister. And I love you for that. I'm not very good at this, though. My dream is very short and sweet.
I've known Josh for the past 6 to 10 years, somewhere around there, in and out. I don't really keep track of our timeline. Josh and I just have a very, very good friendship. I could go on and on about all of our crazy stories that we've had, all of us together, but we don't have time for that. Josh, you're an amazing man, amazing family man, and a great friend. plan on many, many more great memories with us and our families growing together, going for different adventures. It's a different type of craziness, so very grateful for you guys to be in our lives, and glad we've been on this adventure with you guys. And it's been fun, and looking forward to many more years, you guys, so congratulations.
Uh-oh. Josh and Becca. My name's Kurt. Be nice. Yeah, I've known both of these two for about 10 years. I met them at the same time when I moved to Arizona. Knowing what these guys have been through together, I've known them about the same length of time. So, I've seen these guys for 10 years. I'm definitely glad to see these guys finally settling down and making a family. I'm proud of both of you. I hope it works out for the very end. I love you guys.
I just want to say congratulations on a very, very happy Josh. Thank you. Very, very nice. And I appreciate it.
Well, I met Becca on a trip we took to Old Man's Cave when Ben was like 10 years old. He was a little guy. But Josh, we went to Mexico with him, and that was a trip. If you think about Josh, he is a giggle box. He just laughs all the time. He's a pleasure to be around. I can see why Becca likes him so much. He's easy to be around. He's a stand-up guy. Congratulations to you, too.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Never looked back.